described and captioned media program. In the classroom and online, dcmp.org.
Ambrose Video Publishing Incorporated presents A History of American Indian Achievement, Plains Indians War.
A title appears over a native dancer dressed in furs and feathers, A History of American Indian Achievement, then a host.
Hello, I'm Tyler Christopher, and welcome to the sixth episode of A History of American Indian Achievement. Since the disappearance of the mastodon 10,000 years ago, the American Great Plains was a no man's land occupied by vast herds of buffalo. But when the American Indian learned how to ride and breed horses, seven tribes developed a powerful new military culture that moved onto the Great Plains, one that could not only resist white encroachment, but defeat their military. It was the time of great Indian war chiefs, such as Sitting Bull, Geronimo, Cochise, and of course, Crazy Horse. It was the time of the longest military conflict in U.S. history.
Tyler walks away, and a title appears over the Crazy Horse monument in the background. Plains Indians War. Tyler sits backdropped by a group photo of armed Indian warriors.
The first of the great horse warrior Indian nations to come in conflict with the United States military were the Navajo and the Apache. Early on, the Apache were led by the intrepid war chief, Cochise.
Words read 1861, Cochise, undefeated Apache warrior hero. Boulders frame a full moon.
The Dragoon Mountains in the American desert southwest have a spectacularly haunting quality.
A stack of rocks balances on a boulder.
It is a land sacred to and prized by the Apache Indians who once lived there.
Indians in leather clothes and masks.
Indeed, so precious was this area to the Apache that they became the region's greatest warriors, protecting it from Spanish, Mexican, and finally, American invaders.
They wield weapons.
And one of the greatest warrior chiefs was the Chiricahua Apache leader, Cochise.
In a photo, Cochise wears beads and a headscarf.
When the Spanish conquistadors traveled to the New World, the desert southwest was occupied by the descendants of the Anasazi.
Adobe homes with ladders.
They were modern Pueblo Indians that include the Zuni and Hopi.
On a map, four states intersect.
Sometime between 900 and 1400 AD, they were joined by hunter-gatherer immigrants from present-day Canada, the Navajo.
At the Four Corners.
And Apache.
In New Mexico and Texas.
While the Navajo moved towards an agricultural economy, the Apache remained skilled nomadic raiders.
Wagon carts rest outside houses.
When Spanish...
The described and captioned media program provides services designed to benefit students who are blind, visually impaired, deaf, hard of hearing, and deaf-blind. These services include a library of free-loan described and captioned educational media, a clearinghouse of information related to educational media access, a gateway to internet resources related to accessibility, and a center for training and evaluation of any service provider desiring to appear on the DCMP's approved lists of description and captioning service providers. There are no user registration or service fees. Visit the DCMP at dcmp.org. The DCMP is funded by the U.S. Department of Education and administered by the National Association of the Deaf.